Welcome to the Electronic Devices and Circuit Practical Session. My name is Omkar Vaidya, Assistant Professor ENTC Engineering, Sandeep Foundation, Nashik. Now we'll see the Wien bridge oscillator using FET, and we'll build this circuit on multisim, that is simulation of Wien bridge oscillator using FET. So this is basically RC type of oscillator in which in feedback path we are using exclusively resistance and capacitance and its configuration. In case of RC phase shift oscillator, we make a pair of resistance and capacitance such a way that each pair make phase shift, because as we are using single stage amplifier, the input and output, the phase difference is 180, and output through feedback network to input, the phase shift must be 180. Then and then your source signal and feedback signal must be in phase. Then and then we call it as positive feedback. In case of Wien bridge oscillator, we are using two stage amplifier. This is two stage amplifier where we have single stage with our first stage, which is again the same single stage CS unbypassed amplifier, means we don't have CS amplifier, CS that is source bypass capacitor, and in second stage we have source bypass capacitor. And if we say that this circuit is again very common, and already we have studied this type of circuit with these values. The addition in the circuit is this one. This is output of, or portion of output is taken and again feedback to input through certain components, and we call it as feedback components. So truly we can say this is what the amplifier section, and truly we can say this is what the feedback network. So this is a feedback network and this is amplifier section. Now this feedback section consists of resistance and capacitor. One is in series and one is in parallel. So it makes like a Wien bridge. It creates lead lag circuit, so it does not produce any phase shift, and that is the reason why we are using two stage. Means if signal is input is here, its output is 180 degree phase shifted. And again there is a single stage, so their output is given to input of second and there is 180 degree phase shift. So this signal and the signal at here, they are same. So that is the meaning, the feedback signal and original signal, they are in same. So we can say truly it is a positive feedback. And this feedback path does not impose any phase shift. What is the difference between RC phase shift and this type is RC phase shift oscillator gives us sinusoidal frequency of fixed type of frequency, where we can vary or we can adjust the frequency of sinusoidal waveform with the help of this Wien bridge by varying the values of these resistance and capacitances. Now in this case also similarly in case of LC oscillator, we first construct the circuit, we run and we'll see the sinusoidal waveform, and we'll try to find out the frequency of oscillation practically, and we compare the frequency of oscillation theoretically. So we'll run this experiment. So initially it will take some time, and then we get constant sinusoidal nature of the waveform. We'll pause it and we'll find out the time period between them. We can take any peak value. Say this can be a peak value. For For example, this is a time period which is T2 minus T1 803.571 microsecond. So the time period of oscillation is 803.571 microsecond, and if we inverse it, we'll get frequency of oscillation which is 1.244 kilohertz. The theoretical formula is 1/2 pi under root R1 C1 R2 C2, where we are using in the circuit. If this is R1 and C1, the R1 C1, and if this is R2 and C2 and R2 C2, the both values are same. So we can place R1 C1 and R2 C2 are same, which is R, and C1 C2 is same, that is C. So formula become 1/2 pi RC. As we know, the R is 2.2 kilo ohm and C is 47 nanofarad. If we put the value in the formula, we will get 1.539 kilohertz. So the result table gives us the comparison between theoretical and practical frequency of oscillation. Theoretically we have 1.5 kilohertz and practically 1.24 kilohertz. So with the help of Wien bridge oscillator, and it is a two stage, we compare the frequency of oscillation in this case. Wien bridge oscillators are especially gives us low frequency sinusoidal waveforms as compared to LC oscillator, so they are generally used for audio frequency range. Thank you.